What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to create a slat wall or wall slats inside of Revit. So this is really popular these days in interior design, where you have basically these vertical pieces of wood on a wall. I think that's pretty much it, and it looks really, really good. So I thought, why not show you a couple of approaches how you can create that in Revit. So I'm going to be showing you kind of the simple approach, the more complicated approach, and then some additional tips and tricks along the way. Now, before we actually jump into Revit, I would just like to take a moment to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. Now there you can find all of my Revit courses. I've got courses ranging from beginners to intermediate, as well as advanced level topics. There's over 130 hours of content, and I'm adding more each month, so make sure to check that out. Also there you can find some of my customized ready-to-go Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families, and also there is a really useful plugin. Okay, so now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. So I'm just going to go here to Models, to New, to start a new project. And for the template, I'm just going to be using the kind of the default template, so you can all follow along. So we have kind of the same starting point. And here you can see I have my custom Balkan Architect template and all of my other templates that you can find on my website. So I'm going to be including a link to that as well, just up in the cards above. So let's just click here on default metric and click OK. So as soon as Revit starts up, I'm just going to be showing you first the kind of the simpler approach. So for that, I am going to be using a wall. So just go to the wall tool, and then this is the wall, and we're going to be attaching those slats on this wall. Now for this wall, I just want to change the top constraint from the unconnected height from 8,000 to 3,000, or yeah, let's go with 2,600, just something that kind of makes more sense for an interior wall. Okay, so now let's go to the 3D view, and here I just want to see that wall. Okay, and now let's create those wood slats. So for that, I'm just going to be going here again to the wall tool, and then I'm just going to be searching for a curtain storefront wall, and then I'm just going to be placing it in the same place, just like this. Now if it goes towards the inside as it is going here, you can just hit the space key and then it will flip out. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and now here we have that curtain wall. Now we also want to set it to the same height, so that's 2600. Okay, and now we have that curtain wall in front. Now we want to make some changes to this curtain wall. So the first step is to go here to edit type, and then I'm going to duplicate this type and call this wall slats. I click OK. Then for your function, we can turn this into interior, for example. Then for the curtain panel, we don't want any curtain panels here, so you want to set that to, let's see here, curtain panel. It should be an empty option. Here we go, empty. Then you want to go down, and for your horizontal grid, you just want to set that to none. So we're not going to have any horizontal grid. Then you want to go to the vertical grid, and you want to set it to fixed distance and set it to 60 millimeters. The reason for this is because the slats are going to be 30 millimeters. So from center to center of each slat, you want to have 60 millimeters, so the gap is as big of each individual slat. Okay, now let's go down here, and we want to set the vertical mullions from this rectangular mullion to this rectangular mullion 30 millimeters square. Now you want to set this to all of them, so what you want to do is just click on this, so just click and it's going to highlight the whole thing, or just highlight it. Click Control C to copy, and then you just click here, select, Control V to paste, you click and you're done. Again, Control V to paste, click, and you're done. For the horizontal ones, because we don't need them, I'm just going to set all of them to none. Okay, so once we have this all in place, then we can just click OK, And let's give Revit a few moments, delete all of the unnecessary elements, and this is what we end up with. Now here it seems to have some problems. Let's see what the issue is there. Okay, so we have some mullions here on top. So what I'm going to do here is just select this entire wall, and then let's go into edit type. And let's see, do we have something missing here? So this is a bug that could happen here with the horizontal grid. So even though we have set this to none, it's still appearing. So what I suggest to do, you just set it here to 30, hit apply, and then you can see that change here. And then you try to set it to none, and then hit apply, and then just click delete mullions. There we go. And then I think this is also a border type. So let's try here to this. It's not that one. So let's set this back to none, delete, and then just do that with these ones. So sometimes Revit doesn't want to do what you tell it, but there's usually a workaround. There we go. And now it got rid of all of those. And now we have those wood slats. Now, speaking of wood, these aren't actually wood at the moment. So what you want to do is you want to adjust this mullion type. So to do that, you want to go here to the project browser, scroll all the way down, find families and expand that. Here you want to find curtain wall mullions, expand that. And then here we want to find rectangular mullions, expand that. And find the square, 30 millimeter square. Now, if I double click on this, you'll see here we have some adjustments that we can make. The first one is material. So let's go here and set the material to something that's wood. And let's go with birch. Okay, so I've set this to wood and now I can hit apply. Okay, and now one more thing, you wanna change the offset to 30 millimeters. And then just hit apply. Okay, so what this did is if I go back into level one, you can see now if I turn this off, it basically moved this a little bit towards the outside, these vertical mullions. So now in theory, let me see, we do have to double check that and test it out. So let's go here to wall and let's use another regular wall. Let's use the 200 millimeter. And then let's make an arc, something like this. And now you can go here to wall and you can switch this to our wall slats, use pick lines, and then you can just pick this edge. And there we go. Now you want to select that and flip it to the outside. And as you can see here, they are on the outside. Okay, so I think the offset that I gave may have been too much. I gave it 30, actually it needed to be half of the size of the slat, which is 15. So we can just open this back up and then set this to 15. Hit apply, there we go. So now as you can see, it's just going to be kind of exactly glued on that wall. So you can use pick lines to place these wall slats wherever you want. Okay, this is way too high. So we should probably adjust this to be a bit smaller. And then you can do the same thing with this wood slats. So there you go. That's the kind of the first approach. And that's how you apply them with pick lines. So it's a lot easier to apply. And of course, we can go here to the wall and go to edit type and just change the material of the wall to something like, let's go with gypsum just to give that white color. And now if I switch to realistic, what you'll notice is now we have exactly the result that we're looking for. Okay, so now for the next step, I'm going to be creating a curtain wall family that includes both the wall and the wall slats. So this is a bit more complicated. It's not going to work for everything, but it might just save you a few steps if you have a lot of these interior walls to place. So what you want to do is create a new panel family. So just go here to file, new family, and then you want to go with curtain panel. So metric curtain wall panel, hit open. And then for that family, it's going to be really simple. You just want to come here to your reference level, and then go to extrusion, and you want to make it on the interior side off to the side, just like this. And then for the thickness, it's going to be 60 millimeters. And for the length, it's going to be just the thickness of the wall. So if your wall is 15 centimeters, then make it 150 millimeters. And once you have this in place, you want to make sure to lock it. So just like this, you move it away, you move it back, it snaps, and you lock it. And then for these, you can just add dimensions, select the dimension, and lock it in place. And the same should go with this. Make a dimension, select it, lock it in place. Okay, now we hit finish. We can set the material to that wall material. So let's go with the gypsum. There we go. And now let's just go to one of the elevations, like exterior. And you just want to make sure it's locked both on top and bottom. So just like that. And on the bottom as well. Okay, so once we have this, you can save the family. I'm going to skip that step at this point, and then let's just load that into the project. Okay, and now let's go and create a new family, or a new wall family. So you want to go here to wall. You want to find that wall slats. You want to go into edit type, duplicate this family. So wall slats with wall. Okay, click OK, and then here, just for the curtain panel, you set it to that new family that we have created. Obviously, you would have named it and saved it, so you don't get this family tree. Now, if we just click OK, we can place that. So let's go here and place that wall. And as you can see, this is what happens. So you basically get both the wall and the wall slats on the outside. Now it is going to give you issues here. You can see this one is on the outside, so you would have to kind of get rid of that one. You can just unpin it and then delete it if you want. So it's not perfect, but if you have a lot of these types of walls to place, it is just all kind of inside of one family. So it's just a couple of clicks and you have that. And you have that wall. So it's just kind of click, drag out, click, and you have a slatted wall family. Now, I do prefer this original method that I have shown you in the beginning, just because I think it works just a little bit better. Okay, so that's it. That's how you create these slatted walls in Revit. Now, if you want to get access to this project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find those on my Patreon page. So I'm going to include that just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.